Hello and welcome to a new OpenRoads design training video. Today what we're going to be covering is how to create a template inside ORD. If you're watching from the last video, how to create a super elevation, then you're fine. You can just leave that document open. If you're not, or you're starting new for the day, go ahead and open up that super elevation DGN that we created. If you haven't created this yet, then go back and watch that video first and create your super elevation. Once you're caught up to this point, go to make sure that you're in your OpenRoads modeling workflow tab, go to your corridors ribbon, and then go to your create template icon and open that up. Once it's open, you'll notice that you already have two templates inside of here. And before I go any further, let me go ahead and say this outright. A lot of this video today is going to be very similar to how we create templates in SS2. I think maybe the last quarter to a fifth of this video is really what anyone who's used Bentley products before, or in particular our SS2 software, you're only going to get maybe a good 2 minutes at the end of this video of use out of it. For the rest of us who are either new to the program or new to ODOT, I would highly encourage you to finish watching this video all the way through and not really skip ahead. The first thing we're going to do is make sure that you activate your right side only, which is this one right here. So just double click it. It should have a red box around that icon. Once you do that, go to your components up here. Double click to open it. Go to asphalt driving lanes, which is right below it. And then go down to your three layer. Don't double click. We just want this to show up in our preview window. Now, the second thing you're going to want to do before you go any further is come down here to this icon. It's a little circle with a, let's see if I can actually magnify this real quick. Yeah. Let me see if I can. There we go. It's going to look like this. So it's going to be a little circle with two gray dots and a green and red dot at the bottom. Make sure you click on that. That is your dynamic settings icon. Something a little bit different from SS2. Now you don't really have to go through and dig it out of your tools box. It just makes things just slightly easier. First thing you want to do is make sure that your steps in here are set to 1:1. And also make sure that your apply fixes is turned off. So now what you're going to want to do is come down to your preview window, click as close to that origin point as you can, drag it onto your active screen, and place it. You'll notice that it now has a three-lane driving lane here in your right side only. If you do fit view, which is this mountain-looking icon down here, it'll bring up this screen. Now what we're going to do is we're going to double-click on our asphalt backfill and end conditions folder here. Go to three layers again. Grab as close to that origin point as you can. And if your dynamic settings box isn't in the way, go to your TEOD point and attach the end conditions and shoulders to there. What you'll notice that once you place it, it's already going to constrain that point. So that green crosshair that you drove in is now red. Something else that's a little different from SS2 is this is highlighted. Don't worry about it. It's just more of a graphical thing for the computer to look at. And again, if you go to fit view, you'll notice that you now have a full template inside of your design, inside of your create template window. Now what we're going to do is we're going to come down to this typical number. We're going to come down to active template. Go ahead and click on that. Go to parametric constraints and expand it. Go to your third layer asphalt. Double click on that. And then type in your default value. I want you to change that to -5/12. If you reopen that back up, you'll notice it says -0.416667, where it used to say -0.25. So all we've done is just depth a depth adjustment for that pavement layer. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to go to CZ width, which is your clear zone width. Change that 28 to 32. And you'll notice that your clear zone point moves out about 4 feet. Once you've done that, you can go ahead and come back to your library tab, which is right here. And inside your template library, go ahead and close up your components. You don't have to, it's just gonna bug me if I don't. Since I'm already done placing what I have. Right click on your typical number one and go to rename. We're actually gonna add in the start and stop stations. So you'll add in 132 plus not not. And 185 plus not not. It'll highlight it. You'll notice that the name has changed. Double click on it to activate it, and then single click on your right side only. Now come over to your dynamic settings before you touch anything and turn on your apply fixes. Once you've done that, come back down to your preview window, grab as close to that origin point as you can, and drag it on the screen. Now you'll notice you're just kind of moving this around, but you need a left side. So what you're going to do is you're going to right click mirror. You can let go of your left button at this point because it's just constrained to your cursor. And what you'll do is just make sure that you're inside the origin point, which is the pink box, and you're gonna left click. Once you do that, you'll notice that you now have two sides, and not only do you have two sides, but you also have on your right side an underscore R designation for right, and then on your left side an underscore L designation for left. Next, what you'll do is you'll go through and you'll merge your components. So for this template, you're just going to merge your center lanes, your center line points and component locations, and your bottom layer shoulder and driving lanes. Okay, so this is about the point where normally in SS2, and if you go to Fit View, this is what you get, where in SS2 or any Select Series product, we would have just said, okay, template's done. No reason to keep going until we have to adjust things later on down the road. With ORD, that's not the case. When it comes to super elevation, we actually build our rollover locks into the template itself instead of going through the super elevation with super elevation tools. So what you're going to do in order to do that process is to actually go into the edge of shoulder right. So just go to TEOSR. So right there. Double click, come down here to where it says parent 2, click that. You're going to notice that it ungrays this rollover values box. Left click, go to your reference point. You can either click on this or open up your crosshair. But since I know that my reference point is going to be TCL, I'm just going to go ahead and select it. Come down here to your type. In your type, go to high side difference and type in the value -7. Oh, I didn't mean to hit enter. -7. One cool thing about this compared to Select Series is you don't have to go through and type -0.007 or whatever the value is you're looking at to make it a percent. If you type in -7, it makes it that percentage. Leave the left side value alone, it's exactly what you want. And then over here in your second type, go to low side difference. You're gonna notice that the low limit's gonna be negative infinity and your value one for your rollover value is gonna be 0. That's fine, leave it. Hit okay, hit apply, and hit close. Now that we have our right shoulder set up to do a rollover through super elevation. In order to get the left side to do that, all you got to do is the same process all over again. Just go to that point property, go to parent 2, rollover values, select your reference point, which should be TCL. Again, type high side difference, change that 0 to a -7. and your low side difference down here at the bottom to zero. Hit OK, hit apply, and hit close. I'm going to do fit value just so you can see that nothing's changed. It's still the same. All we've done is change that parental constraint. And other than that, that's how the template should look when you're done with a basic template. Go to File and Save. And all that does is update this to your template library for the project. Hit Close. And that is all you have to do in order to create a template in ORD. Now, if you didn't have super elevation on a project, you wouldn't necessarily need to go through the last couple of steps. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please contact Performance and Development or your squad boss. And other than that, we'll see you in the next video.